everybody, it's Damon here from Fender Guitars down at Nevada Music in Portsmouth. Here to show you some of the fab new guitars that Fender brought out at the end of last year, all the way through 2014. So the next guitar that I want to show you is this rather superb, very funky American Special Mustang. Now, it's been a long time since we've done an American Mustang, so it's kind of a big deal. Now, the Mustang was originally designed as a student guitar, as a beginner's guitar, as a first step into the world of Fender, but has been adopted over the years by lots of different players, kind of alternative players, as it has a short scale. So if you're blessed with small hands, like myself, of hobbit-like proportions, it's really easy to play because it's actually a physically smaller guitar, and the body's quite small as well. But what we've done on this one is we've made it super easy to use, super easy to play. We have our three-way switch, master tone, master volume, and the stop tail here. So it's very, very kind of consistent, stays in tune really well, and is really easy to use. Pickup-wise, we have two atomic humbuckers, which are nice and fat and kind of overwound. So kind of path-like, but with more drive and more guts to it. So let's have a quick listen. First of all, to the bridge. Bit more. Now, also, we have a coil tap. So, thins the bridge right out. Okay, both together. Coil tapped. So it's hugely versatile, and in the neck. So, if you're looking for a Fender guitar, but you need something that's a little bit smaller, short scale, but still really, really pokey, so these atomic humbuckers really do have quite a lot of grind and power to them, then the new US Special Mustang is definitely worth a try. We'll be right back. done a load of videos today, played some great guitars. Just wanted to quickly have a little chat about the amps that I was playing through. Last year, we relaunched the 1968 Silverface amps. As you can see here, we have a Deluxe Reverb and we have the Twin. We also do the Princeton, the smaller version, and we are also about to launch the 2x10 Vibralux as well. Now, these amps are based on a 1968 Silverface amp, so just after the Blackface amps finished. We've modded them slightly, we've changed them slightly, so you kind of get a best of both worlds thing going on. So, for instance, on the Deluxe, 22 watts, 1x12, one of the greatest gigging amps, recording amps ever made. So we have a vintage channel, which is based very, very much on the Blackface thing. So, just as you would expect, loads of top end, loads of bottom end. Okay, two 6V6s, so you get that lovely kind of little bit of plummy mid-range in there as well. So we can add to that, obviously, the reverb. And also, of course, the vibrato. And unlike the original amps, the reverb and the vibrato works on both channels. So that's the vintage channel. As I say, that's very much based on your Blackface thing. I can turn it up a little bit more as it's only 22 watts and it will start to drive a little bit more. Now, the super cool thing about these, the new reissue Silverface stuff, is that the custom channel here is much more based on like a tweed style circuit, like you see on like a 59 Basement or a Tweed Deluxe or a Tweed Twin. Those amps are great because what they do is they squish, they compress, and they drive more than the Blackface circuits ever did. So with these amps, you've got the best of both worlds. On the vintage channel, you've got the spanky Blackface jangly thing. And on the custom channel, you've got that lovely, sweet, almost crunchy kind of tweed thing. The other thing that's great about that is that like a Basement or a Tweed Twin, something like that, they take pedals really, really well. I usually gig with a 59 reissue Basement. Anything you put in front of it, Tube Scream or whatever your overdrive pedal of choice may be, it's a lot more forgiving because it's got that lovely kind of sag and compression that you get from a Tweed circuit. So, best of both worlds. Blackface, spanky, clean, and also the tweedy thing going on as well. Next to it, we have the Twin, which is what I recorded most of the demos through today. Same thing, essentially. The only difference being, obviously, it's bigger. It's a 2x12 amp. It's 80 watts, and it's the classic US 6L6 power tube. So, again, these amps will stay clean. They go loud, 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 and they don't really break up. They just stay really, really clean. But the beauty of this is, especially if you have an A-B box, for instance, you can do all your lovely jangly stuff, your funk, your country, bluesy stuff on the vintage channel for that Blackface vibe. Like if you've ever been lucky enough to play through a 65 Blackface Twin, you know, probably the greatest clean sound ever. But again, with the custom channel, you can also use pedals with it and it will start to compress a little bit and it's a lot more forgiving and it will drive really well. A lot of people that I've seen using these already have been doing so with an A-B box, which is a great idea. So into your AB box or into your pedals. Yep, AB box into channel 1, channel 2, custom and vintage, and just switch between the two using the vintage channel for all your clean stuff. Then when you want to use drive pedals, etc., just change it over to the custom channel. So it's almost like having a blackface twin and a 59 basement in one amp. Or if you're doing smaller gigs or you're recording, you want something that's going to break up a little bit earlier, the 22 watt Deluxe is perfect, or even the little 15 watt Princeton is even smaller, probably the ultimate studio amp. So come down to Nevada Music, come and try these out. If you're looking for a new amp and you want that classic Fender clean sound, let's face it, nobody does it better than Fender for the clean stuff, but you'd also like a little bit of extra versatility, an amp that really takes pedals well, then the 2014 Silverface Fender reissue amps could just be the amp for you. So come on down and try them out.